Hey, what's going on everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys how we can create message boxes in Python. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Okay, people, let's create some message boxes. But first, we'll need an import. So from tkinter, import message box. And what this will do is import the message box library. So it's not necessary to add this comment. So we'll need a window. Window equals tk followed by window dot main loop. Let's create a button. So button equals button. We're going to add this to the window. We're going to set the command to execute a click function that will have a message box appear when we click on the button. And let's set the text. So text equals click me. And then we will need to pack this button. So button.pack. Now we'll need to create a click function. So let's do that at the top. Def click. And what do we want to do? So there's a few different message dialog boxes that you can use. So let's begin with a basic show info message box. So message box dot, and there's a few options. Let's begin with show info. Show info. This just displays a simple message. So if we were to run this, we have a button, we click on the button, and it's going to create a message box for us. And it just shows some info, but we don't really have any info to show yet. So we can set a title and we can set a message. So let's set the title. Title equals this is an info message box. Although part of the title got cut off. Let's also set the message. Message equals you are a person. Click me. You are a person. Thanks, I didn't know that. So there's a few other message boxes that we can use too. So for now, I'm just going to turn this into a comment. And I'll just copy this just to save some time. And the next one that we have is show warning. So this will have a different icon. So the title, let's say warning. And the message, you have a virus. So now we get this annoying warning message, but you can just click OK to get rid of it. So one thing that you might see with tech support scams, they'll have a message box like this that shows a warning, but they'll put this within a while loop that's set to true. So this will just continue on and on. Kind of like this. So if we were to try and close out of this, it's just going to reappear. While true is true, basically. So that's just something funny that I wanted to show you. So let's move on. I'm going to turn this into a comment. Then the next one we have is show error. So show error. Title, set it to whatever you want. Error. Message, something went wrong. There's a few more sophisticated ones too. We can ask for some user input. So this next one is message box dot ask, and there's a few to choose from. Let's go with ask OK cancel first. We'll set the title. Title equals ask OK cancel, and a message. Message. Do you want to do the thing? So we can actually put this within an if statement. So this returns either true or false depending on what you click. So let's put this within an if statement. If this is true, print, you did a thing. If it returns false, we can use an else statement. Else, what else do we want to do? We'll say else print you canceled a thing. And let's test this. But I am forgetting a colon. There. Do you want to do the thing? Okay, you did a thing. Let's try it again. Do you want to do the thing? Cancel, you canceled a thing. Cool, there's a few others. So I'll turn all of these into comments. And the next one we can go over is ask retry cancel. And this is fairly similar to what we had before. I'm going to copy this. Let's change this to ask retry cancel. Ask retry cancel. Do you want to retry the thing? You retried a thing, or you canceled a thing. So it's very similar to what we had before. Do you want to retry the thing? Retry. You retried a thing. And cancel. You canceled a thing. Okay, the next one we have is ask yes, no. So we can get some user input if it's a yes or a no. So this returns a Boolean value, a true or false value. So message box dot ask yes, no. And we'll set the title. Title equals ask yes or no. And a message. Do you like cake? So let's put this within an if statement because this returns a true or false answer. Print. I like cake too. Else, they answered no then if this is false. Print, why do you not like cake? And I'm missing a colon, there we go. So if they click yes, this returns true and we execute this line of code, I like cake too. If they answer no, it's going to execute this else statement. Do you like cake? No. Why do you not like cake? Now what we have next is ask question, and this doesn't return a Boolean value of true or false. It actually returns a string of yes or no. So this is message box dot ask question, and we'll set the title to ask question. And a message. Message equals do you like pie? So let's just print the result, what this returns. So print everything within here. So like I said, this doesn't return true or false, but yes or no. So what we could do is assign the response to a variable such as answer. So answer equals whatever the answer is, whatever they click, whatever button they click on. So if our answer is equal to yes, we'll print a message, print I like pie too. Then else, the answer is no. We'll print why do you not like pie? So, do you like pie? Yes, I like pie too. Do you like pie? No, why do you not like pie? So, this next one is probably the most difficult. It's ask yes, no, cancel. So, it's message box dot ask yes, no, cancel. It's this last one. So let's set the title. Title equals whatever you want. Yes, no, cancel. And a message. message equals do you like to code? So let's just print the results, what this returns. So print everything, just so we can take a look. So the possible answers are true, false, or none. So we can just run some if statements for this. So if answer is equal to true, what we can do is print you like to code. Oh, but we need to assign this to an answer. So answer equals all of this. Else if answer is equal to false, let's print, then why are you watching a video on coding? And then else, the response is none, so we can just use an else statement. So else, you have dodged the question. Okay, let's try this. Do you like to code? Yes, you like to code. But this should really be a smiley face, right? Do you like to code? No. Then why are you watching a video on coding? Do you like to code? Cancel. You have dodged the question. Now, one other option available to you is that you can change the icon that you're using. So let's say that we want to change this icon. So right now it is currently this question mark. So we can set this to one of a few preset icons. So icon equals, and let's set this to warning. So instead of that question mark, we get this yellow exclamation point. And you can also use info. It's just an I. And error. So do what fits best for you. All right, well, that's the basics on message boxes in Python. If you'd like a copy of all this code, I'll post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of message boxes in Python. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.